I just thought, how can I possibly live? And how can I go on without this other part of me that's no longer here? And my pastor, that afternoon, he called and he said, Art, and he began to pray. And he said, God, we don't know how to handle this, but we're trusting you. And in the prayer, he began to say, we know that when Paul got to heaven, Lord, he didn't just sneak in and sit down. He burst through those gates because that was Paul. And in here, the Holy Spirit rose up and said, Arlene, quit dwelling on your loss and think about Paul's gain. He's in heaven with me. That was a turnaround moment for me, just turned around. I thought, oh my goodness, he's in heaven. He's experiencing all these things we've heard preaching about, we've sung about, we've talked about, we've read books about, we all our lives, and he's experiencing this incredible journey. Do I have my moments? Absolutely, because there's so many memories. But when I think of Paul in heaven, when I think of him in the throne room before God on his face, I think of him experiencing all the things that we've only read about, it gives me such joy. Makes me want to be there. Makes me want to be there. When your husband passes and you still had the bills that continued to come into the home, a big chunk of my income was gone. And I would say, Lord, how's this going to work out? I remember coming to a telethon. Actually, it was in October. And the Holy Spirit inside said to me, I want you to make a pledge. And usually I'm very quick with it, but I know what my bank account's saying. And so I said, well, Lord, I can't make a one-time pledge. I'll have to do it in monthly, which is a great option. I felt very good. I thought, God, I'm just going to believe that you're going to supply the need. This is my seed in the ground for that need of like about $4,000 I needed. That was on a Monday night. Tuesday I came back to the telephone. A woman came over. We were on the air and she came over real quietly and she said, how are you, Arlene? She said, oh, here's something for you. And it was an envelope like a card. And I said, oh, thank you. And I tucked it in my handbag and I went home and opened it later. And what I pulled out was 20 $100 bills, $2,000 cash. Planting seed in good, fertile ground is the most important thing. And you know, it's your responsibility to know where the good, fertile ground is. Look at the history. What have they done with the dollars that have been invested? How have they spread the gospel? How have they, like Cornerstone, we say it all the time, I say it, this is good, fertile ground to plant a seed. And you will get a harvest. But what I have found in these months since Paul's passed, every time I've had a need, there's been a harvest. God has been so faithful. I'm not somebody special. I just love the Lord, and I trust that when he says seed, time, and harvest, it's really true. It really, really works. It's worked in my life. It'll work in anybody's life. You just have to do it.